Welcome. Welcome to the We Robot Party. So we have quite a show for you tonight. I think you're gonna like it. As you can see, I just arrived in the Robotaxi, the cyber cab. And there's 20 more where that came from. So they've been traveling. They're all, there's no people in them, as you can see. The car's just going by with no people. And we have 50 fully autonomous cars here tonight. So you'll see Model Ys and the Cybercab, all driverless. You'll be able to take a ride in the Cybercab. There's no steering wheel or pedals, so I hope this goes well. So you see a lot of sci-fi movies where the future is dark and dismal, where it's not a future you want to be in. So I love Blade Runner, but I don't know if we want that future. I think we want that that duster he's wearing, but not the the bleak apocalypse. So we'll move from supervised full self-driving to unsupervised full self-driving, where the car, you could fall asleep and wake up at your destination. So it's not just a safe, like it'll save lives, like a lot of lives, and prevent injuries. I think we'll see autonomous cars become 10 times safer than a human. And it's not just the lives saved in injuries, but if you look at think about the cumulative time that people spend in a car and the time that they will get back that they can now spend, well, I guess on their phones, or watching a movie, or doing work, or whatever you want to do. I think the cost of autonomous transport will be so low that like the average cost of a bus per mile for a city is about $1 a mile, whereas the cost of Cybercab, we think probably over time, from the operating cost is probably going to be around 20 cents a mile. And price, including taxes and everything else, probably ends up being 30 or 40 cents a mile. So yes, and you will be able to buy one. we expect the cost to be below $30,000. All right, so our autonomous future is here. As I said, we've got 50 Teslas driving autonomously. We're trying to give you a sense of what cities will be like in the future. And when you get in, you'll see like it's really quite a wild experience to just be in a car with no steering wheel, no pedals, no controls, and it feels great. You know, we have enough vehicles here, so everyone should be able to try it out. So that would be quite fantastic. Oh, and also, what happens if you need a vehicle that is bigger than a Model Y? The Robovan. The Robovan is, we're going to make this, and it's going to look like that. Now, can you imagine going down the streets and you see this coming towards you? That'd be sick. So this can carry up to 20 people, and it can also transport goods. So you can configure it for goods transport within a city, or transport of up to 20 people at a time. So this is gonna, the Robovan is what's gonna solve for high density. So if you want to take a sports team somewhere, or you're looking to really get the cost of travel down to, I don't know, 5-10 cents a mile, then you can use the Robovan. Some people call it the Robovan, but. So yeah, you know, one of the things that we want to do, and you've seen this with the Cybertruck, is we want to change the look of the roads. You know, the future should look like the future. So, speaking of robots, Everything we've developed for our cars, the batteries, power electronics, the advanced motors, gearboxes, the software, the AI inference computer, it all actually applies to a humanoid robot. It's the same techniques. It's just a robot with arms and legs instead of a robot with wheels. As you can see, we started up with someone in a robot suit, sort of down, and then we've progressed dramatically year after year. And I think at scale, the Optimus robot, you should be able to buy an Optimus robot for, I think, probably $20,000 to $30,000 long term. So, and what can it do? It'll be able to do anything you want. So it can be a teacher, babysit your kids, it can walk your dog, mow your lawn, get the groceries, just be your friend, serve drinks, whatever you can think of, it will do. They'll be producing products and services. I predict, actually, provided we address risks of digital superintelligence, 80% probability of a good outcome. Look on the bright side. Now, one of the things we wanted to show tonight was that Optimus is not a canned video. It's not walled off. The Optimus robots will walk among you. Please be nice to the Optimus robots. So you'll be able to walk right up to them, and they'll serve drinks at the bar. And you'll directly, it's a wild experience just to have humanoid robots, and they're there, they're just in front of you. Yeah, with that, let's party! I love you guys too. If you look at that gazebo over there, let's get the party started.